गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड कंटिन्यूइंग द नर्वस सिस्टम चैप्टर इटसेल्फ. दिस इज फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड एंड सेवेंथ सेशन फॉर द फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड इन साइंस. ओके, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द नर्वस सिस्टम. ओके, इन दैट देयर आर मेनली थ्री पार्ट्स इन द नर्वस सिस्टम, दैट इज द ब्रेन, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड एंड द नर्व्स. एंड आल्सो आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द brain. There are three main parts in the brain, that is cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongatum. Okay, in the spinal cord also I have explained you about the parts of the spinal cord, that is vertebral column, spinal cord and spinal cord nerves, spinal nerves. Okay, which runs from the below the brain to the along with the backbone. Okay, it is the bundle of the nerves which passes the messages from the brain to the all over through the body. Okay, next, and also we have learned about the nerves. Okay, nerves. Okay, that there are three main types of nerves. That is sensory or afferent nerves, motor or affective nerves, and mixed nerves. That is sensory nerves. These send the message from the different parts of the body to the brain. And what the motor affective or afferent nerves does? It sends the message from the brain to the all the parts of the body. What the mixed nerves do? Okay, they will send the message to the brain. Again, they will bring back the orders for the other parts of the body. This is how. This is what we have learned in the previous class. Okay, in sensory nerves, I said that it sends the messages from the sense organs to the brain and the spinal cord. Okay, it sends the messages from the sense organs. We have five sense organs. That is, which are they? Eyes, nose, ears, tongue, and skin, which passes the messages through this from the sensory organs to the brain. Okay, in that sensory organs, we are going to learn about the now all the five sense organs. You know, students, which are the sense organs? Sense organs. There are five sense organs. Which are they? Eyes, nose, tongue, ears, and skin. Okay, these are the five sense organs. Okay, the organs which connect us to the outside world are called sense organs. The organs which are connected to the outer world, outer body, they are called what? Sense organs. Eyes, by eyes only we can see. That message can be sent to through the eyes to the brain. And tongue. Okay, we are eating outside food. Correct? No? Okay, we won't produce any food in our body, but we take the food which is prepared in outer. Okay, next sense. If anyone touches us, if anything bites us, we will sense on the skin. Okay, that is the outer part of our body. Next, ears. We hear the sound from the outside. Okay, this sound is passed to the brain through the ears. Tongue. Okay, sense of tongue, eyes, nose, smell. We will breathe the air which is present outside the body. Okay, these are the organs which are connected to the outer side world. They help us to see, smell, hear, taste, and feel respectively. Eyes. First, we learn about the eyes. Eyes are the sense organs of sight. We see various things with the help of eyes. Our eyes are very sensitive. Okay, the eyes are the most important sense organs in our body. We see various things through the eyes itself. Okay, it helps the eyes. Our eyes are very sensitive. Eyes are like a round ball and fit into the sockets of the skull. Okay, eyes are like a round ball. You can see in the picture, it is like a round ball which is fixed into the skull. Okay, this bone like structure is there in our face. So that is a skull which are fixed into that socket. Means how we will fit these features to the sockets? No, in the same way, the eyes are fitted to the skulls which have sockets here. Eyebrows and eyelashes protect our eyes from sweat and dirt. Eyebrows, these are the eyebrows which protect our eyes, and also the eyelashes which does not allow any dust and dust particles to enter into our eyes. It protects our eyes from this sweat and dirt. The front part of the eye is protected by a transparent covering called cornea. Okay, outer layer of the eye is covered with a small thin protected layer called what? Cornea. The colored part of the eye is the iris. The colored part, okay, black color you can see in the middle of the eyeball, no? That is called what? Iris. The black spot in the center of iris is the pupil. Okay, in the black color round like structure, in that again you can see the small black dot. That is called what? Pupil. Light enters the eyes through the pupil. Okay, we'll see anything that will enter through that pupil itself. The iris controls the size of the pupil. Okay, the iris which is around the black. See here, this is the eye. Okay, in this it is the black. Okay, in this again it will be a little bit dark, no white, black color. This is the pupil and this is the iris. Okay, this is not darker like this in the middle. Okay, this is the pupil and this is the iris. Okay, this pupil will from this pupil only what are the things we'll see, no? That will enters with the help of this pupil. This iris will, what it will do, it controls the size of the things. Behind pupil is the lens. Okay, behind this pupil we can say this black color dot here. Behind this there will be a lens which forms the image of the object you see on a screen. Okay, screen called the retina. Okay, beside this pupil there is a lens. Okay, whatever it will say, it will pass to the pupil and the object is screened on the lens. They are called what? What that lens called? Retina. The nerve cells in retina send messages to the brain through the optic nerves. The nerve cells, what it says, in retina sends messages to the brain through the optic nerves. The nerve cells which are present in the retina, okay, this is the retina. Beside that pupil, there will be a retina, that is called a lens. The images which are formed on that, by the help of the nerve cells, the retina sends message to the brain through the optic nerves. The brain reads the messages and enables us to see the object. The brain learns the object and it will enable us to see the object. Care of eye. How we should take the care of an eye? Wash your eyes daily with the clean water. You have to wash your hands regularly with the clean water. Do not read in a very dim light and moving vehicle. It strains your eyes. Okay, you should not read in the dull light, and also while moving the vehicle you should not read in that, because it strains the eyes. Do not watch TV or play computer games for a long time. You should not watch more TV, you should not spend more time with the TV while seeing the, and also we should not play any games, or we should not spend playing in the system, computers and in the mobiles. Never rub your eyes with the dirty hands and or handkerchief. You should not rub your eyes like this with a dirty hand or else the handkerchief. It may cause infection. Sit at least 5 or 6 feet away from the television while watching it. You have to see the television 6 to 7 feet away from the television. Inform your parents or teacher if you feel any difficulty in reading text written on the blackboard. Okay, if you feel any difficulty by seeing the board to write. Okay, if you see the board and write, if you feel any difficulty, you have to first inform your teachers and the parents. Sit erect and hold the body about their foot away from your eyes while reading. Okay, sit, you should sit straightly and the book about their foot away from your eyes. Okay, you should keep your books in this way. you should not keep your books in this way and you should read it. Okay, we have to keep your books properly. Means we should maintain a distance while reading also. Okay, this is about the eyes. Next is nose. This is the main sense organs. Nose help us to smell various things. We breathe through our nose. From the nose also helps us in various things. It helps us breathe through our nose. Inside the nose, there are nerve endings which are sensitive to smell. Inside the nose, there are the nerves which are helps us to sense the smell. The messages are sent to the brain by the nerves. By the nerves only, they will send the message to the brain. Our brain tells us about smell. Okay, our brains will send the what smell it is. The sense of the smell and taste are like. The food does not taste good if the nose is blocked. Okay, whenever you got cold or fever, you can't taste the food correctly because the sensitive nerves which are present in the nose are blocked. You can't taste the food properly. Okay. Care of nose. Keep your nostrils clean by blowing them gently. You have to keep the nostrils. These are the mucosa. No? They are the nostrils. You should keep clean always this one. Do not use your finger to clean the nose. You should not use this finger to clean your nose. Clean the blocked nose by inhaling steam. If your nose is blocked, you have to take the steam. Okay. Next is about the ears. We have two ears. One on either side of the head. We have the two ears which are either sides of our head. There are the sense organs of ear. These are the sense organs of hearing. We are able to hear various sounds with the help of our ears only. We can hear the sound with the help of these ears only. They also help us. They also help us to keep our balance. The part of ear we see in the outer ear, it is like a funnel that collects sounds, waves and passes them to the eardrum that separates the outer ear from the middle ear. Okay, we have the interior structure of the ear. Okay, this is the, what we call this structure is called? Sounds with the help of the ears only. The part of the ear is the outer ear. It is like a funnel. Okay, this is the outer ear. It collects the sounds and sound waves and it will send to the inside ear. That is the eardrum. That separates the outer ear and the middle ear. The eardrum starts vibrating like the skin of tabla when struck. Okay, when the sound comes, the eardrum which is present in the ear, it will start vibrating. When we hit the tabla, okay, how the skin will vibrate in the same way, the eardrum which is present in your ear, it will start vibrating. This vibration passes into the ear, into the inner ear where nerve cells are present. Okay, this in the middle ear, this vibration will occur and the nerves which are present in the middle ear, they will send the messages to the inner ear and the nerve cells which are present in the inner ear, they will send messages to the brains. Okay. Next is about the care of ears. How we have to take care of our ears. Never put any point object in your ears. Okay. You should not keep any sharp object or point object to clean your ears. Use earplugs while swimming. Okay. While swimming, you have to put the earplugs in your head. In your ears. If water enters to your ear, clean them gently with an earbud. If any water drops are entered into your ear, you have to clean that water drop with the help of the earbuds. You get no. Do not listen to very loud sounds or for a long time. You should not listen more loud sounds for a long time. Okay, this is about the ears. Next come for the tongue. Tongue is the sense organs of taste. Tongue is the main sense organs and dog is used to talk and also to taste the food. We can taste the various food with the help of our tongue. There are tiny bumps on the tongue. These bumps contain some sense called taste buds. Okay, कि अपॉन योर टंग यू कैन टच एंड यू कैन सी दैट सम ऑफ द बबल्स आर फाउंड फाउंड ऑन द टंग. इन दैट बबल्स यू कैन सी द टेस्ट बड्स आर प्रेजेंट इन दैट. देयर आर फोर काइंड्स ऑफ टेस्ट बड्स इन डिफरेंट एरियाज ऑफ अ टंग. ओके, देयर इन दिस टंग देयर विल बी ए फोर टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्ट बड्स आर द आर फाउंड व्हिच हेल्प अस टू टेस्ट इन डिफरेंट टेस्ट. They help us to taste sweet, salty, sour and bitter food items. Tongue also enables us to speak. Okay, so many different four groups of senses are present in on the tongue, which helps to taste sweetness, salty, sour and bitter also. And tongue is also helpful for the enables us to speak. How to take care of the tongue? Clean your tongue with daily with the tongue cleaner and clean. Water. You have to clean your tongue with the tongue cleaner you get in the shops, and also with the water you should clean your tongue. We do not eat very hot or very cold food. We should not eat the very cold and very hot food. Stick the curtains. The outer ear collects sound waves and passes them to the dash. Okay, the outer ear collects the sound and passes to where? Ear canal, eardrum or anybody. Okay, it passes sound to the eardrum itself. Tiny bumps on the tongues are called as receptors, ligament or taste buds. They are what? Taste buds. Lastly, now we are going to learn about the skin. Sense organ skin. Skin is the sense organ of touch. Okay, if we touch anything, we will feel with the skin itself. It covers the entire surface of our body and protects us against injuries and germs. Okay, it covers completely from the top to bottom of our body and it protects against the injuries and the germs. It has nerve ending that help us feel heat, cold and pain. Okay, it has the all the nerves are ending with the skin which help us to feel heat, cold and pain. Then how should we take care of the skin now? Okay, how should we take care of the skin? Daily bath with clean water and soap to clean dirt and dust. And use a clean towel to dry your body after bathing. Okay, this is the structure of a skin. Okay, skin cells. Okay, this is the structure of the skin. This is upper on the face. Then this is the upper layer of the skin. Below that there will be so many layers and so many nerves are present on the skin. In the skin. Okay, daily you should bath with a clean water and you should wash your body with the soap to clean dirt and dust and use a clean towel to wipe your body also, to dry up your body after bathing. Always you should wear the clean clothes. If you wear any dirty clothes, means the fungus will grow on your skin. Okay, the infections will get for you. Avoid scratching your skin when it itches. When you get itching, you should not scratch the skin. Apply antiseptic cream to any scratch or wound to prevent infection. You have to apply the antiseptic cream to cure the wound or for infection. Do not apply any ointment on your skin without consulting the doctor. You should not use any other ointments without consulting the doctor because it may damage your skin also. In warm weather, wear loose clothes in order to allow the passage of fresh air. Okay, in the warm weather, in hot weather, you should always wear the loose clothes in order to allow the air to pass throughout the body, which helps them to dry up the sweats or dust. Okay. Okay, children, this is about the skin and. And some of the multiple choice of has been already. Okay, in the previous page 191, they have given multiple choice question. Add all activities of our body are controlled by the dash. Brain, spinal cord and muscles. It was controlled by the brain itself. The largest part of the brain is dash. Which is the largest part? It's the explain, you know, cerebellum, medulla oblongata. Okay, which is the largest part? Cerebrum is the largest part of the brain. And some of the multiple questions also they have given here. Take the part. Which part of the brain controls the involuntary actions of our body? Cerebrum, cerebellum, or medulla oblongata? That is cerebellum. When we get the smell of some tasty food or mouth watering because of that reflex action, muscular action, relaxation because of the reflex action. Food tastes better when we can eat, feel it, see it, or smell it. When we feel the food taste, when we feel the smell of your food is good and the taste is also become good, the smell is the answer. Students, this completes your session 7 and also the lesson nervous system. Okay, in the next class we are going to learn about the health and hygiene. It's a very small lesson, we can complete it in one session. Okay students, only 3 lessons are left. It is 6th, 7th and 8th lessons. If you have any doubts regarding this, you can call me students or text me.